So, hello everybody. As you said, so I'm from BMW here in Munich, and I'm working for in the department for development of car bodies, concepts and architecture. And I'm doing optimizations mostly in the field of crash simulations. And today I will present you how we implemented an automated process for updating CATIA files for optimization purposes. And I did it together with the colleagues from Beta CAE systems. So we internally call this automated process CAPOS. CAPOS is an acronym for CATIA parameter optimization in the simulations. And the process is schematically represented in this picture. So we start from a parameterized cut part, and where we vary some parameters. Then we update the cut part. We translate it. We translate it in ANSA and batch mesh it. And we replace then the updated part in our submodel. We send it to the system simulation and data management system at BMW, where the part is assembled in the whole vehicle structure and is simulated in the APC cluster. And then the results are collected, and response surface is built on the results from the DOA, from design of experiment, and then the part is optimized. And the wall works automatically. So, as I said, starting from the a parameterized cut part. The motivation for that is that normally, what we do also today at BMW is that we have two separate worlds, the construction and simulation. So first, the construction develop a concept design with design space and manufacturing informations. Then the design is saved in a CAD part and saved in the BMW construction database Prisma, and then the simulation engineer take this part, mesh it, and assemble in the whole structure. Then it is solved post-process, and mostly some optimization cycles are necessary if the parts does not fulfill some requirements, so functional requirements or weight requirements. And after some of these optimization cycles, normally a new design is required. So the optimized part has to be sent back to the construction, and a new design is developed, and then it has to be verified again or possibly also optimized again. And to avoid all these inconsistencies between construction and simulation, and avoid also these back and forth cycles, the idea was to use directly CATIA parameters in our optimization workflow. We had to face several challenges to arrive to an automized process, because as I said, construction and simulation are two separate worlds that communicates with much difficulty, and so we had to establish a communication between the FE tool, so ANSA in a Linux environment, and the CAD environment tool, so CATIA in Windows. And we had to ensure the interoperability between these two operating system platforms. And then we had to enable an automatic transfer of the parameters from the CAD files to the FE submodels and backwards. Because so the important thing for this process to proceed automatically is that the parameters are synchronized between CAD and CIE. Another challenge was to integrate the CAPOS process within the BMW environment, and especially in the crash environment. Because what is represented here is the simulation and data management system, what is called CIA Bench 2 at BMW. So it's an integrated solution with access to all pre- and post-processing tools and to resource computer resources. And it enables a fully automated process, so from assembling until report of the results. So we had to enable a communication between the tools used by CAPOS with this simulation and data management system. Because the part that we update, so that we want to optimize, is containing the sub-model that is shown here. Can I see? So the sub-model has to be updated. So when we run a design of experiment, the sub-model has to be updated in each experiment and then has to be sent back to the system for simulation and post-processing. And so we had to enable the communication and data exchange with this system at BMW. And to tune the process, to test it, we used we applied it to a crash load case. It is represented here. So we optimized the rear door side impact beam subject to door pushing. So this is a quasi-static load case where a rigid cylinder is pressed against the door that has to withstand with a minimal force, you know, this intrusion. And this is schematically the process that we develop. So we start from an initial geometry that is not okay. So you can see, for example, here is the model is represented in the deformed state, so at the end of the simulation. And in the initial geometry, it tears in the middle and it does not withstand with the, so it does not fulfill the requirements for the minimal force, resistant force. And so we parameterized the geometry in CATIA together with our construction departments, and we defined some parameters for that we thought together with our simulation engineer they were the most important parameters for the parametrization of this the part. And then the important step is this ANSA parametrization, where the CATIA parameters are so the CAT part and the CATIA parameters are read into ANSA, and the optimization workflow is set up in ANSA itself. And then we ran a design of experiment, and on the basis of that, as I said, we made an optimization, and at the end we could arrive to a structure, so this optimized geometry that is lighter, and it doesn't tear anymore as the initial geometry. How the process was developed? This is a quite complicated picture. It represents the simulation process, data and resource management architecture. And but what the user sees in the end is only this middle layer. So everything below and above remains for the user not visible. But so what does this SPDRM server does is it responds to requests from the user client. So whenever a user client in ANSA starts an action, for example, the parse of CATIA parameters or the update of a CAT part, then the SPDRM server launches a dedicated beta apps launcher, in this case, this beta apps launcher one, in the Windows environment where CATIA is open and these actions are performed. For example, the parsing of CATIA parameters or update of the CAT part. And whenever this action is concluded, then a second beta apps launcher is started where the translation of the updated CAT part and the batch meshing is performed. And after that, in parallel ANSA session, the updated sub-model is then locally output and saved and sent to the simulation and data management system. And the two main workflows are so that are done in ANSA are the parsing of the CATIA parameters, as I said, so I don't see it here below, and the update of the CAT part. So from the picture below, it seems everything very complicated, but in the end for the user, it resulted to be quite simple. So the user has to prepare an ANSA section where various functions, for example, the parse of CATIA parameters or the CAT part update can be introduced in the optimization workflow via user actions. So for example, to import a CATIA file in ANSA from the construction database, from this Prisma database at BMW, we have this user action, this function translate and position CID for CIE, where the user has to only to give the identification number of the part that wants to be imported, and then batch meshing and can be directly performed on the import part. So the part is can be with a couple of clicks imported in ANSA, the CAT part, and translated and batch meshed. And an important thing is that this imported file, imported CAT file, has user attributes defined on it, which are important for our process because they contains the path to the source CAT part. Although in this particular pilot project, the CAT part was not so complicated. So you can see it contains the main part, this side beam, side impact beam, and it contains also other parts like screws, beams, and so on that must not be updated in each design of experiment. So the only thing that has to be updated is the main part, and all the rest must be taken over from the original FA submodel. So in the FA submodel, there is the main part, other parts, but also sets and contacts that has to be, as I said, taken over. And on the other side, on the CAT part, user attributes are defined on the part, and these are important because they connect the part to the source CAT part. So we had to merge these two files to have, in the end, a submodel containing the required information on the part to be updated. Once we did it, the rest can be performed from the user with some simple clicks. So for example, to parse the CATIA parameters, so once we have read the part in ANSA, we can parse the CATIA parameters with this user action in the model browser. And the CATIA parameters are then read and defined as design parameters in the model browser. And afterwards, one can decide which parameters should be active in the optimization. So, and they can be defined also with a couple of clicks as design variables. And then they are automatically added to an optimization workflow in ANSA, where the user, also in this case, by means of very simple actions, can introduce some functions in the optimization workflow. For example, here we have the script, this update cat part task, that in each baseline run calls this SPDRM server that in turn starts the two beta apps launcher. So this script perform the update for the cat part for the particular combination of CATIA parameter and in the specific design of experiment. And after the CATIA update, the part is translated and batch meshed. And the user can also add some other functions, like, for example, a renumbering or some checks. For example, the renumbering is important because after batch meshing, the nodes and the elements will have random number, but for our complete workflow to work, each submodel has to be precise numbering convention, so nodes and elements IDs must be in certain ranges, so that the assembling in the simulation and data management system can run smoothly without problems. But this so can be done quite easily in the optimization workflow. So the user, as you can see, doesn't see this underlying layer where and everything has been automated. So automatically, when the script is executed, the SPDRM server launches the beta apps launcher that perform all these operations. So as I said, we did this optimization for this side impact beam. We use in this case five parameters, and here below you can see in red from the initial geometry and in green the optimized geometry, where mostly so we use as parameter, for example, the breadth and the depth of this middle embossing, middle bead, or the teeth of the depth of the external profile and some draft angles. And so in the end, we arrived to an optimized geometry which is lighter, what we normally try to achieve, and also perform much better than the original one. The process didn't run smoothly from the beginning, so because in the beginning what we used to for the update of the cut part was the so-called fertig tile solid. So it's a cut part that contains construction details, like, for example, this embossing or manufacturing informations. And so all these details caused a lot of fails in our automatic update in CATIA. And then, together with the colleagues, with beta colleagues, and with the construction colleagues at BMW, we decided to perform to define a new solid, new body in the cut part that has the same basic geometry as the original one, but where construction details and some manufacturing details are not defined. And by doing that, so we could have much better results. So the hit rate of our design of experiments was increased from 45 to 82%. So in the end, we got enough data for the optimization. So to conclude, what I can say is that a process has been developed that allows the use of CATIA parameters directly in ANSA as design variables in our optimization workflow in the BMW environment and especially in the crash environment. But the process is quite stable now and generalizable, and therefore it's suitable for a larger user base. So we plan to extend it to Abacus explicit simulations, for example, or to use it to optimize extruded parts, or to update more cut parts in each experiment, and so on. But these are all, we will work on it. But I'm pretty confident that we will manage to extend the capability of this process. Then a new SPDRM server architecture is available at BMW that also guarantees a greater stability and a better communication between ANSA and CATIA, and also a better feedback from CATIA, because in the beginning it was quite difficult to understand when problems happened in CATIA. And but now it's, we are going in the right direction.
Ready. So thank you very much, Mr. Gavarini.